Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. Today I am starting a new topic from special toxicology. As you know, we have discussed general toxicology in the beginning of the session. Now this special toxicology I am taking up with the topic of irritant poisons. Why they are called irritant poisons? Because they cause irritation in body. If you recall classification of poisons, there are six types of poisons groups, like corrosives, irritants, neurotics, cardiac, asphyxiants and pharmacological. So I will take up irritant poisons from today, and then it will keep on going discussing special toxicology. The topic of special toxicologies are divided among between two of us. My first topic in special toxicology is irritants. Today's topic is classification of Today's lecture topic is classification of irritants and acute phosphorus poisoning till the treatment part. Then remaining acute phosphorus poisoning and chronic poisoning of phosphorus I will discuss in next lecture. The poisons will become easy to understand if you describe under certain headings which remain the same for all poisons, like sources, physical properties, mode of action, active principle, signs and symptoms, diagnosis, treatment, autopsy findings, and sample collection and medico-legal aspects in each poison. In next slide, I will tell you about the sources of studies. You will study PAREK for these irritant poisons, section 9, chapter 42, and from my lecture notes. Now, outcomes of specific poisons. Since we are starting from these special toxicology, there are certain outcomes which UHS and HEC has provided to us. Study of poisons, drugs of abuse prevailing in our society along with medico-legal aspects is recommended. Emphasis must be given to the following poisons, drugs. So they want us to emphasize the following poisons in special toxicology. Number one, alcohol. Number two, opiates, opioids and other narcotics. Number three, salicylates and paracetamol. Number four, hypnotics and sedatives. Number five, stimulants, cocaine and cannabis. Number six, poisonous plants, aconite, belladonna, hyoscyamus, stramonium, digitalis, ergot, mushrooms, nux vomica, oleander, tobacco. Number 7, venomous insect snakes. Number 8, inorganic elements like antimony, arsenic, lead, mercury and phosphorus. Number 9, volatile poisons like corrosives, carbon monoxide, carbolic acid and alkalis. Number 10, pesticides, herbicides and insecticides. Now I come to classification of irritant poisons. So as you know by your previous knowledge, this classification was discussed in general toxicology under the classification of poisons in general. But here I revise only classification of irritant poisons. They are divided into three main groups: inorganic, organic and mechanical. Now, inorganic irritant poisons are further divided into non-metallic irritants and metallic irritants. Examples of non-metallic irritants are phosphorus, iodine, chlorine and bromine. Now, metallic poisons examples are arsenic, mercury, lead, copper, zinc and thallium. Number two main group is organic irritant poisons, which are again divided into two. Number one, vegetable irritants, and number two, animal irritants. Now, vegetable irritants examples are castor oil seeds, croton oil seeds, Erbus precatorius, etc. And animal irritants examples are snakes, scorpions, and spiders. Number third main group is mechanical irritant poisons. Examples are diamond dust and powdered glass. Now, what are general features of irritants? Now, I am discussing the general aspects before taking up specific each poison one by one. Like first I will take up phosphorus, but before that I will like to discuss general features of irritants. Now, these irritants, they cause symptoms of gastroenteritis and marked depressant action after absorption. So, these symptoms of gastroenteritis, by these effects, they look like some disease of GIT like cholera and diarrhea. Onset of symptoms and signs within half to 1 hour. A burning sensation in mouth and throat, thirst, then dysphagia, which is difficulty swallowing, then retching, then vomiting, diarrhea, shock, convulsions, coma, and the patient may die if not recovered. So this whole process may take place from burning to death within 24 hours to few days. So the outcome of poisoning is either recovery or death. Now, post-mortem appearances are evident to naked eye. So if you perform autopsy on dead person who died from poisoning of irritant poisons, you can examine in the tissues, GIT and other tissues, redness or ulceration in stomach, duodenum and rectum. That means they are easy to diagnose on autopsy. Now, that was about general aspects. Now, I will discuss first non-metallic poison, that is phosphorus. And it will be almost all poisons discussed will be in two aspects will be discussed. Number one, acute poisoning of that poison and chronic poisoning of that poisoning, because most of them have acute as well as chronic effects. So they will be discussed separately so that you are not confused and mixed up. So first I will take up phosphorus. Its forms and characters. There are two types of phosphorus poisons as far as form and morphology is concerned. They are called white and red. Number one, white or yellow phosphorus. White or yellow is same. Its properties are, it is crystalline, translucent, waxy, luminous cylinders. It is insoluble in water. It should be kept submerged in water to prevent ignition, because if you keep it outside, it may in the presence of oxygen may catch fire. On exposure, dense white fumes of phosphorus and phosphoric acids are luminous in dark. that is called phosphorescence. So they, you can see them in dark, they are visible, they are that is called luminous, they are luminous. Now number two type is red phosphorus, which is entirely different from white or yellow. It is inert, it is amorphous, it is non-luminous, it is odorless, and no, it gives no fumes. So it is entirely opposite to white phosphorus. Now there are certain derivatives of phosphorus or compounds which are used as poison, like aluminium phosphide and zinc phosphide. They are also called wheat pills. Also phosphorine gas is also derived from phosphorus. Now uses of phosphorus, it is used in following areas. Number one, in military, in weapons, in bombs and other weapons. Number two, fireworks. This fireworks is very common these days on special occasions. Phosphorus is used here because of its luminosity. Number third, as insecticide or rodenticides. Rodenticide means rat killer. Then number four area is safety matches. This red phosphorus is used in making of safety matches. In this slide you can see pictures of phosphorus, white and red, both. Now what is acute phosphorus poisoning? Mode of action of phosphorus in acute phosphorus poisoning. It's a protoplasmic poison, that means affects cellular oxidation, causing ischemia and anoxia, which results in diminished metabolism, which is called necrobiosis in liver, in which deposition of glycogen is inhibited while deposition of fat is increased. So in chronic exposure, it interferes with bone growth, leading to necrosis. Symptoms and signs of acute phosphorus poisoning are in two phases, primary and secondary. Number one, primary phase, it starts within 2 to 6 hours. There is pain in upper GIT, thirst, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, garlic taste and odor. Number two, vomitus, which is dark, smells garlic. It is garlic-like smell, luminous in dark. Stools, they are dark, luminous and offensive. So luminosity of vomitus and stool is diagnostic. Primary phase lasts 1 to 2 days and has two outcomes. Severe, number one, severe, victim dies from collapse and cardiac failure. Number two, remission, that means there may be reduction in the symptoms. Remission for 2 to 3 days. Now secondary phase is due to absorbed poison. Mainly it causes damage to liver and kidney. It's one of the hepatotoxic poison, that means liver damage, causing liver damage. Other hepatotoxic poisons are, other than phosphorus, are alcohol, arsenic, paracetamol and iron. Now in early stage, liver is enlarged, which is called necrobiosis. In late stage, liver is shrunken due to necrosis, which is also called acute yellow atrophy. Now purpura and epistaxis may be seen due to hypoprothrombinemia. Feces are pale. Urine is scanty, that means less amount. Concentrated, acidic, contains blood, albumin and bile. Nervous system symptoms are pain, insomnia, tinnitus, impaired vision, formication, that means feeling of creeping insects under the skin, cramps and paralysis. It causes abortion in pregnant women. Now, death from hepatic and renal insufficiency. Fatal dose of phosphorus is 60 to 120 milligram. Fatal period is 6 to 7 days or longer. Now, at the end, we come to treatment of acute phosphorus poisoning. It is the principle of treatment is it is directed at removing unabsorbed poison from GIT and providing supportive care. So there are two main objectives of treatment. Number one, removing unabsorbed poisons from GIT, and number two, providing supportive care, that is life-saving procedures to save life. Demulcents are contraindicated. If you recall your general toxicology, these are mechanical antidotes. They are called demulcents. They are not used in phosphorus poisoning because they are fatty substances and phosphorus itself is fat soluble poison. Number two, gastric lavage or stomach wash is done with 5.5% solution of potassium permanganate, which oxidizes phosphorus to harmless phosphates. If that is not available, then you can perform gastric lavage with dilute solution of copper sulfate. So both these may be antidotes of phosphorus. Then you can give purgatives to remove it from stools. You can also apply or give liquid paraffin to retard absorption. This liquid paraffin will act as mechanical poison instead of demulcents. Then IV intravenous saline to treat shock. If the patient is in shock, you can give IV saline. If blood calcium is reduced, you will give calcium gluconate. Sodium bicarbonate can be given to maintain alkali reserve. Dextrose is given intravenously to protect liver. Hemodialysis or peritoneal dialysis is done in case of renal failure. Now, for skin burns, you can use copper sulfate solution topically. So, these were some of the salient points of treatment of acute phosphorus poisoning. We will take up rest acute poisoning and chronic phosphorus poisoning in the next lecture. Thank you.